We're in Amsterdam in the TQ office with Toucan Toko, where I'm speaking with Jan Toutan, Country Manager Netherlands. Jan, can you tell us something about the background of Toucan Toco and briefly explain data storytelling?
Of course. 5 years ago, Toucan Toco, the founders of Toucan Toco, reached the conclusion that organizations invest a huge amount of money in BI tools. And the challenge organizations face is that the data, their own data, is not reaching the people from the business. And at the end, the people from the business, they are using basic Excel spreadsheets to have access to the data of the organization. And this is where Toucan Toco positioned itself. The data storytelling is to tell a story with the data of the organization to the people of the business in a very simple way for people who are not used to work with data, in a very simple way so they can make business decisions based on the data of the organization. I am thinking about the fact that every morning when I go running, well, every morning, almost every morning when I go running, I use my smartphone and a very nice app on my smartphone to monitor my performance. And this app will tell me, Jan, you have to run 1 mile extra, or you have to run faster, or you have to run slower, any decision I can make based on the data I generate and that is being collected and distributed to me by this platform. That's what I love when I go running, because then I can make decisions based on my own data. And when I then take a shower and arrive at the office, the whole story collapses and I'm in front of a big pile of data that I have difficulties to understand. But this is not about running data, this is about company data. So I have to make decisions on a huge amount of data with a huge impact for the company, and it's being presented to me and offered to me in a way that is much more difficult to understand than the data I use for my running practice. And that's the added value for organizations. Thanks to Toucan Toco and the data storytelling approach we have, they have in a very simple way and at a glance the data of the company so they can make decisions.
And how do your clients use data storytelling from Toucan Toco? Can you mention some business cases, some use cases?
Of course. We have about 300 platforms running at the moment in the market. And one of the examples about people who use the data in a very simple way, for example, are the dealers of Renault cars who use the platform to manage the stock of spare parts. As simple as this. So the platform is, of course, is mobile first. So you have access to the data of your company on your smartphone or on a tablet. And therefore, for the case of Renault, the dealers have access to the data of their stock management on their smartphone, and they can make decisions in order to improve the stock of the spare parts in the dealerships.
Well, thank you, Jan. Can you give us some more examples, perhaps?
Yes, of course. I'm thinking about Sodexo, the catering company, which uses the platform to help the restaurant managers to do the forecasting of the meals they are going to serve in the coming days, and therefore to order the right amount of supplies. Food supplies, which are food supplies that if you keep them too long, they just have to be thrown away. So thanks to a better forecasting, they can adapt the management of their supplies and then improve the costs in the restaurants.
And what kind of professionals are served with your solution? What are the technical skills that you need to work with Toucan Toco?
Do you need technical skills to work with Uber?
Not really.
Okay, well, that's the good answer. The user doesn't need any technical skills. It is as simple and as intuitive as a platform like Uber or Spotify. For the backend, for the people who are working on developing the platform, there is a very simple way to connect the data of the company and the visualizations that we provide. We call it the studio, mm-hmm. And the studio is developed every day to make it every day more easy for the developers to build the platform.
Yeah. Okay, talking about that, you bring a lot of connectors to the most widespread CRM tooling. Is this plug and play, or what do you need to implement this?
Yeah, so connectors are very important for us because this is a way to have access to the data of the company. Yeah? The data is there already and is spread in different tools, SAP, Salesforce, and so on. We have the connectors to go and collect the data directly from those softwares. And we make it as simple as possible to connect the platform to those tools with the connectors, with APIs that we have developed specifically for those main platforms of the market. About 60 platforms we have connectors for today.
And what is the license model that you use?
We offer access to the platform for a flat fee per month and unlimited number of dashboards. And then we have a price per user per month that depends, of course, on the number of users.
Okay. You're operating here from Amsterdam. Can you tell us about your growth plans for the upcoming period?
Of course. So we have the intention to have a good development on the Dutch market, to stem the Dutch market with the platform. The team is growing at the moment. We are recruiting people, sales, delivery, and the intention is to have achieved about 200 customers in 3 years' time. And we are talking to many large organizations, corporate businesses.
Okay, well, thank you very much, Jan.
Thank you, too.